a song about celebration. This is called The History of a Tough Motherfucker. It's a poem by Charles Bukowski. I'm just going to do a C and F all the way through, see how it goes. Came to the door one night, wet, thin and beaten and terrorized, a white cross-eyed, tailless cat. I took him in and I fed him and he stayed, and he grew to trust me, until a friend drove up the driveway and ran him over. I took what was left to the vet, who said, "Not much chance here. Give him these pills. His backbone is crushed, but it was crushed before and somehow it mended. If he lives, he'll never walk. Look at these x-rays. He's been shot. Look here, the pellets are still there. And also, he wants his tail, but somebody cut it off." I took the cat back, it was a hot summer, one of the hottest in decades. I put him in the bathroom, gave him the water in the pools. He wouldn't eat, he wouldn't touch the water. I dipped my finger in it, put it to his lips. I didn't go anywhere. I put in a lot of bathroom time and talked to him and gently touched him, and he looked back at me with those pale blue crossed eyes. And the days went by, and then he made his first move. Dragging himself forward on his front legs, the rear ones wouldn't work. He made it to the litter box. He crawled over and in. It was like a trumpet of a possible victory, blowing in that bathroom and into the city. I related to that cat. I'd had it bad, but not that bad. Not as bad as that cat. One morning he got up, stood up, fell back down, and just looked at me. "You can make it," I said to him. He kept trying, getting up and falling down. Finally he walked a few steps. He was like a drunk. The rear legs didn't want to do it. He fell again, rested. Then get up. Well, you know the rest. He's better than ever. Cross-eyed, almost toothless. But the grace is back. That look of victory, it never left his eyes. And now sometimes when I'm interviewed, they want to hear about life and literature. I get drunk and I hold up my cross-eyed, shot, run-over, detailed cat. And I say, "Look, look at this." But they don't understand. They say something like, "You say you've been influenced by Celine." And I hold up the cat. But what happens? By things like this, by this, by this cat. I shake the cat and I hold him up in this smoky, drunken light. He's relaxed and he knows. It's then that the interviews end. Although I'm proud sometimes when I see the pictures later, and there I am, and there's the cat, and we're photographed together. He too knows that it's all bullshit. But that somehow, being with that cat, it all helps.